to video lecture series on remote method invocation. In today's class, we'll be learning about how to activate a remote method invocation in Java. So the first part is we will be developing an interface here. So I'm just developing an interface, import java.rmi.star. So this is the default package which you want to import. Next, you should write an interface, public interface, and I just name this interface as my interface. Okay. So it should extend remote interface here. So why we are extending this remote interface? Because whatever the methods you are going to make here will be activated as remote methods. And since this is an interface, you should have only abstract methods here. Okay. So I will have two abstract methods. Public string welcome. Welcome is called as the name of the message. Okay. And it should throw an exception here. So throws exception, and we'll put a semicolon here. So since this is an abstract method, the method does not have any body. And now public, we will have an integer value, integer say for example we'll have a multiplication here, and UL int a and int b. So I should have two parameters here. So throws exception. So now this file is called as an interface file, where it has two abstract methods, and this abstract methods has to be implemented in the subsequent classes. Now we will name this file as, see the, what is the name of the interface? It is called as my interface dot my interface. So we will just name this as my interface dot java. So where I have to store? I will be storing in d colon java programs. I have a class here, folder here, Java programs. Inside this Java programs, I am going to save this file as myinterface.java. So, just please ensure that the file name and the class name or interface name are identical. Okay. I have saved this. Now, interface has been given here. Now, we will just provide an implementation for this interface. So, how to provide an interface? Yeah, implementation. So, import java.rmi.star, so that's the package here, and then the implementation is going to be provided. So I am just using import.java.rmi.server.star. So one more thing, now I just have a class called as public class, and interface name is my interface. I just use my interface underscore implementation. Okay, extends, so it should extend an unicast remote object. So unicast remote object. Okay. And you have to implement all the methods there. So implements the interface called as my interface. Mission show. Okay. Now first thing is I have to make a constructor. So what is a constructor? The name which the method which has the same name as a class is called as a constructor. So I simply make it as public my interface underscore implementation. Okay, so it should actually throws an exception here. So throws exception. Okay, now in order to call this class, okay, this is called as a super class, whereas this class my interface underscore implementation is called as a subclass. So if I want to call the super class or parent class, I simply use a class called a super class. Super, this keyword will actually call the super class here. So why we are calling it? So whatever the objects we are going to make it, that is going to be a remote object. So to make it as a remote object, we are calling this class as unicast remote object. Now I have two abstract methods. The first method is public and return type is string, and it is welcome. Okay, and it should actually throws exception. So I just going to provide the implementation here. So return have a nice day. So this is an information which is going to be returned to this method. Okay, and the next is return type is int, and the name is actually called as, I just call this name. Name is comp- computation. I think I just verify the name here. 1 minute, please. We'll verify what is the name of that method. So my interface.java, I will just open with Notepad. Okay. Now the yes, the name of the method is MUL. So we will just use it MUL here. So public int MUL and int a comma int b. So we can have any names here. So throws exception. Now I will return a star b. So multiplication symbol. That's it. Okay. Now close the class. Now what you have to name is, you have to name this implementation class. The name of the implementation class is called as myInterface_implementation. So we will save this file with the same name and the same folder in Java programs. I save it as all files myInterface_implementation.java. Okay, the job is done. Now the next important part is you have to write a server here. So how to write a server? Now we will write a server. So I will start with import java.rmi.star. Okay, and then import dot java.rmi.registry.star. Okay, and now I have to write a class here. So public class, we will write it as a server. Okay, server. And now this should have a public static void main, because we are going to run a client or server. So we will have public static void main. Now string, and you can give any name here, and I just give it as g here. Okay, so close this main method and close the class. Now the most important thing what you have to do is, whenever you are writing the code for a server or client, you have to write it inside the try and catch block. So I open a try, then I will have a catch block. Exception, something called as E here. So not mandatorily you have to provide E, you can give any variable name. So what happens is, if any error arises in this try block, catch will actually handle that error. Okay, so in order to know the error, we can just type it as system.out.println. Okay, this is sufficient. So this will actually get you the error in case of error arises. Now the first part what you are going to do here is, you are supposed to create a registry. So registry, okay, I just create reg is equal to, now locate registry dot create registry. Now listen carefully. Now you have to provide a port number here. So any port number within the range of 0 to 65535. Let us assume that I am going to provide you the port number called as 13200. This is my port number. Okay, so this port number should be used for communication. Now the next step is, I have to create an object where the implementation is given. Okay, so the implementation is given in my interface is underscore implementation. Okay, and you create an object here, obj is equal to new of my interface underscore implementation. This is done. Now since I have provided an object now, so use the reference of a registry. So you have to bind this object to the registry. So reg dot rebind. Okay, so the first parameter is, you have to provide a remote name for this. I just provide our name. Our name is called as a remote name, and the object is actually called as obj. Okay, so the name which is provided here is called as our name. Our name is actually nothing but the new name which is provided for the object. That means this is called as a remote name, where you can access it using an RMI URL. So I just make it as system dot println. Okay, I just go here and make it a server ready to respond. Dot dot dot. That's it. once a server is ready, now we can save this file in the same folder. So in Java, C colon, T colon Java programs, I can save this file as server.java. Okay. Now only one thing is left over here, that means we have to make a client. Okay. So I am just import java.rmi.start. Okay, rmi.start semicolon and public class client. So again you should have a main method here, public static void main, and then string, and you just provide any variable here, gj. So now close this. Now once you have written the client, so only one thing which is yet to do is actually you have to create a RMI URL. Okay, so how to create an RMI URL? So first thing what you have to do is, so what is the name of the registry? You create a reference for a registry, a name of the interface. Okay, so name of the interface is called as my interface. Let us assume that MI is called as my interface reference, and now I just create naming dot lookup. So you are going to just look into the remote object. So you have to write a URL rmi/. Okay, my remote object exists in my same machine. Okay, and where it is existing, what is the port in, port number? The port number is 13200/. Okay, and what is the name of it? Okay, remote object name is called as rname, which we have already provided in. Okay, and one more thing is yet to do. Now this is called as an URL, and in the ref side you have a reference for an interface. So what you have to do is there will be a mismatch. So you just make a typecasting here, my interface. Okay, just perform the typecasting. That's it. Once this is done, you can do it. But before that, try to write inside the try catch block. So always try to write inside the try catch block. So I just write catch exception and E, and inside this exception I can show that system dot out dot println E. Okay, now only one thing is left. Actually I have to use this reference here to call the methods. So I'll just use system dot out dot println, and the reference name is MI, and I call the method. First I want to call the method called as welcome, so it should return me that have a nice day. And the second is I will just call the multiplication method, assume system dot out dot println and MI dot MUL, and we just assume that we will just pass two values, 12, 10. So obviously I should get the value called as 120 here. So once if you do this, now save this file as client.java. Now I save this file as client.java. That's it. Now if it is done, we can actually compile this program. So how to compile it? Okay. So I just go to cmd and go to D colon, so CD Java program. So this is the place where I have all my Java programs. You can just check it out. Okay, I have client, I have server, I have my interface. Okay, and then I have interface implementation. So what we will do is we will compile first the interface. Okay, we'll compile the interface first. Now how to compile it? So Java C, and interface name is my interface dot Java. Okay, no issues. Now next is I will compile the interface implementation. So my interface underscore IMPL dot Java. Okay, no issues in the second program also. Now I will compile the client server. So Java C server dot Java. Okay, so no issues in the server also. Now compile the client, Java C client dot Java. Okay, now you have to run a client and server, isn't it? So in this, which you have to run first? That means you have to run the server and then correspondingly you have to run the client. Okay. So first ensure that whether the server is running properly. So I am just making Java type server. Okay, server ready to respond. But you cannot run the client here. Because why? Because if you try to run it, server will close off. Okay, so you keep this prompt as it is. You once again open a new prompt, cmd. So I have opened a new prompt, d colon java underscore programs. Okay, now I will take this prompt. Okay, now I will run this client here, java client. Okay, so you are getting a message called as have a nice day and the value is 120. Okay, so this is how actually you can execute an RMI from a command prompt. Okay, so thanks for watching the video. Have a good day.